Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Today is our lesson number 22. In this lesson, we will study Venn diagram involving three sets. Now, we have started chapter number 2 of D4. We have finished the topics and questions of New Syllabus Mathematics D2, chapter number 14. Now, in this lesson, we will study Venn diagrams, shading and problem solving involving three sets. Now, this is the Venn diagram, which has a universal set and three sets A, B and C. This Venn diagram has different regions. One is this, which is outside all the circles. One region is this one, and this one. Each region represent a particular set. This is the region which is common in all the three sets A, B and C. This region, this region is common in A and B, and this region is common in A and B but not in C. So let's discuss different regions in this Venn diagram. We will move outwards. From this point, we will move outwards. Now this whole region in which there is this purple color dot, this region is which is common in all A, B and C. So this region belongs to all the sets A, B and C, or this can also be written as A intersection B intersection C in terms of set notation. Now this region is common in A and B, but this is not in region in set C. So this region is A and B but not C, A and B but not C, or we can say A intersection B minus C. And this region, which is from this region, this is B and C, but this region is B and C but not A. So it is B and C but not A. This region is not included in this, or this can be written as B intersection C minus A. Similarly, this region is A and C but not B, or this can be written as A intersection C minus B. And this region, which is this region is only A, and this region is only B, and this region is only C, and this region, this one, is universal set minus A union B union C, or none of A, B and C. None of A, B and C is this region. So this is when we are given numbers in different sets. So we can write each element by using this. And if you are asked to, now in this we will again study the shading of three sets. This region, which is common in A, B and C, or this can be written as A intersection B intersection C, as we have discussed in the previous slide. This region, now look, this region is common in A and B and C complement. C complement belongs to this region and this region, but A intersection B is this region. So this region is common in A intersection B but intersection of C complement. A and B but not C. This in certain notation can be written as A intersection B intersection C complement this region. And this region is B and C but not A. And in certain notation this can be written as B intersection C intersection A complement. And this region is A and C but not B. But not B mean B complement. So this can be written as A intersection C intersection B complement. This region is A only, or this can be written as B union C complement. B union C complement mean वो region जो B union C में ये circle भी है और ये circle भी है, तो इसकी union का complement mean जो इसमें नहीं है, तो वो ये वाला region होगा और ये बाहर वाला region होगा, और A के साथ इसका intersection का मतलब है ये वाला region. So ये जो A only है, it mean it is B union C complement intersection A. And this region which is B only, so this will be written as A union C complement. क्योंकि ये region A वाला circle और B वाले circle के बाहर है, तो इसका मतलब इन दोनों circle की union के बाहर, इस दोनों circle की union के बाहर का मतलब है complement. So A union C complement intersection B. क्योंकि A union C complement में ये वाला region भी होगा और ये वाला region भी होगा, लेकिन B में यही वाला region है, तो दोनों में common कौन सा हुआ, ये वाला. So this one is C only, and this can also be written as A union B. A union B complement, A union B complement outside A and B and intersection C, this one. And this region is outside all these three circles. So it means this region represents A union B union C complement. A union B union C complement. So we will shade the required region of the Venn diagram having three sets, and we will solve problems. Now the examples of problems are in the next two slides. We will start from this and we will move outward, starting from this, then we will write fill this one, and then we will fill these regions and then this region. Now this is the problem. This type of questions will be asked you to solve by using the Venn diagram. In a class 85 students play football. We do not know the number of students in a class. So from a class 85 students play football one game, 72 play cricket one game, and 43 play tennis. So these are the number of students which play only one game. And then 44 students play both football and cricket, 15 play both cricket and tennis, 25 play both football and tennis, and 4 students play all the three sports. Each kid play at least one sport. So it means there is no student who play none of the three games. So you are asked to find the total number of students in the class, number of students that play cricket and tennis but not football, number of students that play only football. So because there are three games, total students will be represented by the universal set, and for the universal set we will use a rectangle. And for different games, football one circle, tennis other circle, and cricket other circle. So we will start filling this part. If we are given, agar hame ye diya hua hai ki teenon students, teenon games kitne students खेलते हैं, तो हम यहाँ पे वो नंबर लिख देंगे। अगर हमें नहीं दिया हुआ कि ये तीनों स्टूडेंट्स जो हैं, तीनों गेम्स कितने स्टूडेंट्स प्ले करते हैं, तो इसकी जगह पे हम एक्स लिख देंगे। अब यहाँ पे हमें उसने कहा है वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द मिडल एंड वी विल मूव आउटवर्ड्स, सो वी विल मूव बैकवर्ड। फोर स्टूडेंट्स प्ले ऑल थ्री मीन वी विल राइट फोर हेयर इन दिस रीजन। So four is there. Now 25 play both football and tennis. Football and tennis. 25 play both football and tennis. Look, this is the region which is for football and tennis. 25. This region. Out of 25, we have already written four in this region. इस region में football और tennis की बात वो कर रहा है। फुटबॉल और टेनिस 25 खेलते हैं, उन 25 में से 4 ऐसे हैं जो क्रिकेट भी खेलते हैं, तो बाकी कितने रह गए जो फुटबॉल और टेनिस खेलते हैं, दे आर 21। देखें यहाँ पे अगर उसने कहा होता ना 25 प्ले बोथ फुटबॉल एंड टेनिस, अगर ये कहा था 25 प्ले फुटबॉल एंड टेनिस ओनली का मतलब है, तो फिर हम इस रीजन में 25 लिख देते, फिर उसने दे नहीं कहा। अब 25 प्ले बोथ फुटबॉल एंड टेनिस, हमें ये नहीं कहा उसने कि वो क्रिकेट नहीं खेलते। देन 15 प्ले बोथ क्रिकेट एंड टेनिस, क्रिकेट एंड टेनिस 15 है, तो ये रीजन है जो क्रिकेट और टेनिस के लिए है, कॉमन है। उन 15 में से 4 हम पहले से लिख चुके हैं इस रीजन में, तो बाकी जो है वो इस रीजन में आ जाएगा, तो ये सारे मिलके जो है वो 15 बन जाएंगे। ये 15 स्टूडेंट क्रिकेट और टेनिस खेलते हैं, बेशक वो फुटबॉल भी खेलते हैं साथ। अब ये वाला रीजन जो है, ये बैक साइड पे जाएंगे तो 44 स्टूडेंट्स प्ले बोथ फुटबॉल एंड क्रिकेट, 44 फुटबॉल और क्रिकेट खेलते हैं। फुटबॉल और क्रिकेट वाला रीजन ये वाला कॉमन रीजन है, 44 खेलते हैं, उन 44 में से 4 हम यहाँ पे पहले से लिख चुके हैं, तो अब बाकी जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं उनको हम यहाँ पे लिख देंगे इस रीजन में, सो दे आर 40। नाउ We will fill this region and this region. Moving backward, 43 play tennis. अब tennis जो खेलते हैं 43 है। अब tennis वाला region कौन सा है, circle कौन सा, ये वाला tennis वाला circle है। Out of 43 who play tennis, 21 play football also, 4 play all the three games and 11 play cricket also. So how many are left which play tennis only? So out of 43 we will subtract all these, out of 43 we will subtract 21, 4 and 11, the remaining are the students who play tennis only. Come to this, 85 play football, this one 85, out of 85 you will subtract all these, because this is the circle which is represents football. So out of 85, if we will subtract 21, 4 and 40, we will left with 20, and 72 play cricket. So out of 72, we will subtract 40, 4 and 11. So this is the circle which represent cricket, and 72 people represent play cricket. So if you will add this number, this number, this number and this number, this will become 72. And 43 play tennis only. So 43, out of 43 you will subtract 21, 4 and 11, and remaining will be written here. So this is 7. You are asked to tell the total number of students. So there is no students who do not play any of these three games, because it is said that each kid play at least one sport. So total number of students will be, we will add up all these numbers. So total number of students will be 20 plus 21 plus 4 plus 40 plus 7 plus 11 plus 17, and this will become 120, I think. And number of students that play cricket and tennis but not football, cricket and tennis but not football, so it is 11. This is the region which is represented by cricket and tennis but not football. Cricket or tennis, ye sare hai, sara hai. Lekin ye sara cricket or tennis के अलावा फुटबॉल को भी रिप्रेजेंट करता है, लेकिन उसने कहा है कि फाइंड द नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स हु प्ले क्रिकेट एंड टेनिस ओनली बट नॉट फुटबॉल, तो ये वाला रीजन होगा जो कि 11 स्टूडेंट्स हैं, एंड नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स दैट प्ले ओनली फुटबॉल, तो ओनली फुटबॉल मीन दिस रीजन विच इज 20. लेट्स लुक अनदर एग्जाम्पल, लेट्स टेक अनदर एग्जाम्पल, दिस इज अनदर एग्जाम्पल. इन दिस एग्जाम्पल 40 स्टूडेंट्स, अ ग्रुप ऑफ 40 स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ टोटल नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स आर गिवन टू अस. आउट ऑफ दीज 40 स्टूडेंट्स 22 आर टेकिंग मैथमेटिक्स, 18 आर टेकिंग बायोलॉजी, 14 आर टेकिंग केमिस्ट्री, 9 आर टेकिंग मैथमेटिक्स एंड बायोलॉजी, 7 आर टेकिंग मैथमेटिक्स एंड केमिस्ट्री, 5 आर टेकिंग बायोलॉजी एंड केमिस्ट्री, एंड 2 आर टेकिंग ऑल दी 3 कोर्सेज. हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स आर नॉट टेकिंग एनी ऑफ दीज कोर्सेज? So because there are 3 subjects, so we will draw a Venn diagram having 3 circles like this. One circle for mathematics, one for biology and one for chemistry. We will start filling from this because we are given that 2 students take all the 3 courses. So we will write 2 here. Then 5 are taking biology and chemistry because 5 takes biology and chemistry. Out of 5 we have written 2 in this region, so remaining 3 will be written here. Then 7 take mathematics and chemistry, mathematics and chemistry 7. Out of 7 we have written 2 here, so remaining will be written here 5. And 9 are taking mathematics and biology, 9 are taking mathematics and biology. Out of 9 we have written 2 here, so remaining will be written here, so it is 7. Now all the 14 are taking chemistry only. 14 are taking chemistry. This is chemistry. Out of 14 we have written, this circle represent chemistry. Out of these 14 we have written some numbers here. 5 plus 2, 7 plus 3, 10. So the remaining will be written here in this region, which is 4. And 18 are taking biology. Biology is this circle. Out of 18 we have written some numbers here, so remaining will be written here. 7 plus 3 10, plus 2 12, and out of 18 we are left with 6, and which this is written here. Now mathematics, 22 are taking mathematics, so this circle represents mathematics. Out of 22 we have written 7 2 and 5 here, so remaining will be written in this region, which is 8. And it is also, so we are asked to find how many students are not taking any of these courses. None of the students, we are asked to find the number of students who do not take any of these. So it means it is represented by this region, and we do not know what number we will have to write here. So we will write here X. This is unknown. Now because we are given the total number of students, which is 40, so we will add up all these numbers and we will put this equal to 40. So let's look at the solution. It is this. This is our equation. 8 plus 7 plus 2 plus 5, 6 plus 3 plus 4 plus x. All these numbers are equal to 40. So we will add, solve this equation to get the value of x. 35 plus x is equal to 40, x is equal to 40 minus 35, and x is equal to 5. So it means the number of students who do not take any of the 3 subjects is 5. Hence number of students not taking any of these courses is equal to 5. So this is the way of solving problems involving set and 3 sets by using the Venn diagram, like this, as we have solved these 2 examples. So in the coming lesson we will solve some more problems from your book and the exercise. Hope this topic is clear. The Venn diagram, shading and problem solving by using 3 sets or 3 circles. This is my profile. Thank you for watching, and Allah Hafiz.